In this video, we will discuss about some of the ranges. In our previous video, we have discussed about the domain and range of sine inverse x and cos inverse x. Okay, so here is a chart that is also given in your NCERT book, that what are the domains and what are the ranges of the different trigonometric functions or trigonometric ratios. So these are the ratios or domains that we have found by 1-1 onto function. 1-1 onto functions. It means that every image has its pre-image. Okay. Or every pre-image had its image. Okay. So here we have the domains of some of the part like sine inverse x, domain will be -1 to 1. Okay. Because for sine x, the domain is -π/2 to π/2. And for inverse, domain and range flipped each other. Okay. So here domain is -1 to 1 and range will be -π/2 to π/2. Okay. So for cos inverse, cosec inverse, here are the domains and here are the ranges that you need to know. Although one more property is there, that if sine inverse x and sine x, okay, the value of this, or also we can write simultaneously here, sine inverse x. Okay, so these two are different functions. So the value of this part, will be x. Okay, and here also it comes x, but here it comes x when x belongs to, look, here we have to take the part of sine x. So for sine x, the domain will be -π/2 to π/2. We are talking about sine x, not sine inverse x. Okay. So for sine x, the domain is -π/2 to +π/2. Okay. So here, if this x belongs to a angle, okay, we need an angle here. Okay, so if sine x belongs to angle, then sine inverse sine x is equals to x. But for here, we need a value of sine inverse x. Okay, so for sine inverse x, domain will be, what will be the domain? -1 to 1. So here we need the value of 1 as integer. Okay, we need the value of x as integer. So we can say that sine x into sine inverse x is equals to x. Okay, so these are the two values that you have to keep in your mind, that whenever sine inverse sine x, it is x when x belongs to the domain, that is -π/2 to π/2. Okay, this is the domain for sine x, because here we are taking the value of sine x. Okay, and here it is sine inverse x, so domain of sine inverse x is -1 to 1. Okay, so here for this x we need the integer value, and for here we need the radian value or theta. Theta means angle. Okay, now let's move to exercise 2.1. so here is some of the questions. Like first question, it is given that sine inverse -1/2. Okay, so in our, we have already discussed that sine inverse sine x is equals to x when x belongs to -π/2 to π/2. Okay, so from here, what we will have, we can write this as sine inverse minus sine 1/2 is the value of sine 30. Sine 30 means π/6. Okay. Now here we have learned that sine inverse sine x. But here in this question it is sine inverse minus sine π/6. So since we have sine minus theta is equals to minus sine theta. Okay. We have learned about the angles, that here add sugar to coffee means all sine and cosec, tan and cot, here cos and sec. Okay, so here if we take sine minus theta, it means that sine 0 minus theta. Okay, so 0 minus means it lies in fourth quadrant, and in fourth quadrant sign is negative and the value does not change for 0 and pi. The ratios does not interchange in 0 and pi. Okay, but if we talk about y axis, the sine will change into cos and cos will change into sine. So here we have sine minus theta is equals to minus sine theta. Okay, so this minus sine theta here, we can write it as like this. Here we can write sine inverse sine minus pi by 6. Okay, here we can write it like this. Okay, and we know that the principal value branch of sine inverse x is equals to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Okay, the value of sine lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Okay, so here this is my pi by 2 minus and this is plus pi by 2, 90 degree. Okay, so minus pi by 6 lies something here. Okay, so this comes in between the value of sine. Okay, remember the graph we have already learned in our previous video, that this is the principal branch for sine inverse. Okay, so minus pi by 6 will lie somewhere here. Okay, so now we have the value minus pi by 6 as our answer. Okay, now let's do another question, that is cos inverse root 3 by 2. So for cos inverse root 3 by 2, we can write it as cos inverse cos root 3 by 2 is pi by 6. Okay, cos 30 is equals to root 3 by 2. Okay, so from here we have cos inverse cos x, like same that sine inverse x we have learned here, that sine inverse sine x is equals to x whenever this sine x belongs to its domain. Okay, so here if the principal value branch for cos inverse is 0 to pi. Okay, this is the like this 0 to pi. Okay, so here this is the value of cos x and pi by 6, this is the pi and this is 0, so pi by 6 will lie something here, so it is coming between 0 to pi. Okay, so from here we have the value pi by 6 as our answer. Okay, now if also look at the example, like question number 5 in your NCRT, it is given cos inverse minus 1 by 2. Okay, cos inverse minus 1 by 2. So here we can write it as cos inverse minus cos 1 by 2 is the value of cos 60. Okay, so pi by 3. But like here sine minus theta is equals to minus sine theta, but we know that by right angle property cos pi minus theta is equals to cos theta minus cos theta, because pi minus theta, pi is 180 minus theta will lie in second quadrant and cos is negative in second quadrant. Okay, so from here we have the value cos inverse cos pi minus theta, and here theta is pi by 3. Okay, so from here we have the value cos inverse cos 2 pi by 3. Okay, and now we have cos, now and this value 2 pi by 3, okay, it lie in this quadrant, second quadrant. Okay, so from here we are getting the value between 0 to pi, because the domain is between, the range is between 0 to pi. So here we have the answer 2 pi by 3. This is our answer. Okay. Now let's move to question number third, that is cosec inverse 2. So cosec inverse 2 can be written as cosec inverse. Now cosec 2 is the value of cosec 30, and cosec 30 means cosec pi by 6. Okay, and we know that cosec inverse cosec pi by 6, and the value of cosec, the range of cosec is between minus pi by 2 to from here to here, this, but we are not taking 0. 0 does not comes in the range of cosec, because cosec can be written as sine, and sine 0 is 0. So 1 upon 0 gives us the value infinity, and we don't want infinity. So if it comes x is equals to 0, then we cannot take the value pi by 6. Okay, but here pi by 6 will lie someone here. Okay, because this is 0, this is minus pi by 2, and this is plus pi by 2. So here plus pi by 6 will lie in first quadrant. Okay, so this gives us the value pi by 6, and this is our answer. Okay, all we need to do is look at the ranges and domains of all the trigonometric ratios. Here the range of cosec, we are having here cosec pi by 6. Okay, so cosec inverse, the range of cosec inverse, we have to write the statement, the value of the principal value branch is between minus pi by 2 to, this is minus pi by 2, this is plus pi by 2. In between this minus, what is the range of cosec inverse? That minus pi by 2, these include, so we will put here close brackets, pi by 2 minus 0. Okay, we will subtract 0 from these two values. The range is between these. Okay, so from here we get the answer pi by 6. Now we will do for sec. So sec inverse 2 upon root 3. Look, for cos inverse, root 3 by 2 is the value of cos 30 degree. Okay, so here also it is the value of sec 30 degree. Then it is sec pi by 6. Okay, so here the value of sec. Now we have to look at the range of the sec inverse. So what is the range of sec inverse? It is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, but here look, sec can be written as 1 upon cos. Okay, 1 upon cos. So here minus pi by 2, we have open brackets both sides. Means minus pi by 2, plus pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, minus 3 pi by 2. We does not include these values, because for pi by 2 cos is 0, and 1 upon 0 will give us infinity, and we does not want infinity in our range. Okay, because infinity does not have its pre-image in its domain. So from here pi by 6 will lie here. This is the pi by 6. Okay, because it is the 30 degree angle, this is pi by 6. So here we have the answer pi by 6. Okay, now question number 4, tan inverse minus root 3. So tan inverse and minus root 3 is the value of minus tan 60 degree, that is pi by 3. Okay, but here we know that since tan minus theta is equals to minus tan theta, because in fourth quadrant only cos and sec is positive. In fourth quadrant only cos and sec is positive. Okay, so here we have, so we can write this minus tan pi by 3 minus tan theta as tan minus theta. Okay, so here we have tan inverse tan minus pi by 3. Okay, and we have now the value of tan, the range of tan lies between 0 to pi. Okay, sorry, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Okay, the range of tan inverse. Okay, so here minus pi by 3, this is minus pi by 2, minus pi by 3 will lie here, minus 60 degree. Okay, and this is minus 60 degree. Okay, so it will lie something here. So it is lying between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2. Okay, so we can say that here the value is minus pi by 3. The answer is minus pi by 3. Okay, now let us talk about cot inverse. Cot inverse minus 1 upon root 2. Sorry, cot inverse minus 1 upon root 3. So for cot inverse minus 1 upon root 3, it is the value of minus cot pi by 3. Okay, because cot 60 is 1 upon root 3. Okay, so it is minus, but we know that since, look, if we take cot minus theta, this will give us the value minus cot theta. Okay, this gives us the value minus cot theta because in fourth quadrant only cos and sec is positive. So from here we can write minus cot theta, this is minus cot theta as cot minus theta. Okay, so we can write it as cot inverse cot minus pi by 3. Okay, and we know that the principal value branch of cot inverse is, now for cot, what is the range? Range is 0 to pi. Okay, here the value lies between these. This is the principal branch. Okay, from 0 to pi. So here minus pi by 3. Okay, here look at the minus pi by 3. So here it is pi. So here we have the answer minus pi by 3. Now let's do another question, that is question number 11. So for that we have to find the values of following functions. So here it is given that tan inverse minus 1. So this tan inverse minus 1, the value of tan 45 is 1. So we can write here tan pi by 4. Okay, in radian, 45 degrees can be written as pi by 4. Here, cos inverse, this is minus 1 by 2. So the value of cos 60 is 1 by 2. So here we can write cos pi by 3. Okay, plus sine inverse. Here, minus 1 by 2. It is minus sine 30 degree, that is pi by 6. Okay, but since we know that cos pi minus theta is equals to minus cos theta, also sin minus theta is equals to minus sin theta. So here this can be written as same tan inverse tan pi by 4. Okay, plus look, here cos inverse will be written same, but minus cos pi by 3, minus cos theta means minus cos pi by 3, can be written as cos pi minus pi by 3. Okay, so here we will write here cos pi minus pi by 3, and here it is sin, this minus sin theta, this is minus sin pi by 6, can be written as sin minus theta. Okay, sin minus pi by 6. Okay, so from here we will have the value tan inverse tan pi by 4 plus cos inverse cos 2 pi by 3 plus sin inverse sin minus pi by 6. Okay, so here tan inverse tan pi by 4 is pi by 4 plus cos inverse cos 2 pi by 3, because the principal value of cos lies between 0 to pi. So 2 pi by 3 lie between 0 to pi. Okay, so here we have 2 pi by 3, and here it is minus pi by 6. So this is minus pi by 6. Now we have to take the LCM. So the LCM of 4, 3 and 6 will be 12. Okay, so from here we are having 3 pi plus 3 4s are 12 and 4 2s are 8, 8 pi minus 6 2s are 12 minus 2 pi. So 8 and 3, 11 pi minus 2 pi. This gives us the value 11 minus 2, that is 9 pi upon 12. 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12. This gives us the value 3 pi by 4. And this is our answer. Okay. Now, question number 13. In this question, it is said that sine inverse y, sine inverse x is equals to y. So, what are the values? Now, we just have to look at the range of sine inverse x. So, the range of sine inverse x lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, so here the value of y also lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, so we have to see, this is our answer. So answer number B, this is our answer. Now the last question of this exercise, that is tan inverse root 3 minus sec inverse minus 2. So tan inverse root 3 can be written as 10 pi by 3. 1060, okay, minus sec inverse minus 2. The value of sec here, minus sec, look, cos 60 is 1 by 2. So here also it is pi by 3. Now we know that the value of, since sec minus theta is equals to plus sec theta, so we don't want it because it will become, so this is sec pi minus theta. This gives us the value minus sec theta. Okay, so here tan inverse 10 pi by 3 is minus sec inverse sec pi minus pi by 3. So this gives us the value pi by 3 minus 2 pi by 3. And this gives us pi minus.